Good evening and welcome back to this special WDSU Hot Seat Music Tribute. Tonight, two living legends, Fats Domino and Dave Bartholomew. Joining us in studio now is music historian and Fats Domino biographer Rick Coleman. And he's the author of Blue Monday. Nice to see you again, Rick. You won the ASCAP Award, which is a national award for best music biography for your book about Fats Domino and Dave Bartholomew called Blue Monday. Why did you call it Blue Monday?
Blue Monday, well, it's the favorite song of Fats Domino and Dave Bartholomew, and it kind of typifies the situation that they were in. It was actually a very hard time for them as they worked to bring the crossover of rhythm and blues over to pop music and became rock and roll.
What made it so hard for them?
Well, of course, it was the days of discrimination and segregation, and they had to go through that, especially Fats, because Dave mostly stayed in New Orleans, but Fats had to go all over the country and, basically kind of struggled. But when he when he finally did cross over with Ain't That a Shame, it like opened the world for him. So he suddenly appealed to white audiences, and it's amazing the appeal that he had nationwide. And suddenly kids were coming out of the woodwork to come to his shows.
Hence the big celebration by the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Why is this so significant?
Well, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame obviously has, wanted to recognize Dave and Fats, and they're both in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And, they're honoring their legacy finally, amazingly when they're in their 80s or 90s. And, it's a great thing. I don't know that they really have given New Orleans and Fats Domino and Dave Bartholomew their proper due, and now they are.
It was interesting because I got a call from the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame just the other day, and they wanted to make sure that the people of New Orleans understood that this was not just a tribute to Dave and Fats, but rather a tribute to the entire city and its unique contribution to the history of American music.
Yes, definitely, and they've had several other New Orleans people up there. And they've had Lloyd Price and Irma Thomas and the Rebirth Brass Band and Dr. John are all going to be performing. So it's going to be a great celebration in New Orleans. And if you can get your last minute tickets and get up there, I would suggest that you do.
We'll get back and talk to you more about your book. But let's delve in a little bit more about this fantastic duo looking at Dave Bartholomew. You know, mm-hmm. It was a decade ago that Dave told me that he hoped he and Fats could record together again and make magic. One more time. From the very beginning, though, both men were from worlds apart.
Fats has the magic, but it was Dave Bartholomew who showed him how to use it. Born in Edgard, Louisiana in 1920, Dave became the man of the house at an early age. He grew up in New Orleans. His musical roots came from the big band tradition. Bartholomew took lessons from the same man who taught Louis Armstrong to play trumpet. He perfected his writing and arranging skills in the U.S. Army during World War II.
Without Dave, there wouldn't have been a Fats. Not the Fats that we know and love. And, by the same token, I don't think that Dave would have achieved the high recognition and the prestige that he enjoys in the music industry had he not molded a star.
Well, we caught up with Bartholomew a couple of days ago at home getting ready for the big showdown at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Norman, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Dave. The question is, how are you doing?
Man, I'm doing fine. So nice to see you.
At 89 years old, rock and roll pioneer Dave Bartholomew is still going strong. He's looking forward to the Fats and Dave tribute by the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Words can't express the way we feel. Fats and I were together a couple of months ago, and man, we're just elated over everything that's actually happening to us because we've been very, very lucky, and we love New Orleans.
Dave says he's most happy these days to be back home in Pontchartrain Park, which was badly damaged during Hurricane Katrina.
The wind and everything tell us what to do. Katrina didn't listen to us, but we're here, so we won.
Producer, composer, arranger, and trumpeter, Dave Bartholomew and Fats Domino were winners from the very start. It was Bartholomew who brought Fats to Imperial Records in 1949.
What's the favorite song you ever produced with Fats?
Well, I would say Ain't That a Shame.
Ain't That a Shame?
Because what actually happened, when you go someplace and you're rooting for a team, you know, man, I wish they win. I wish they win. And sometimes, you know, we don't be as lucky as we have been lately. Mm-hmm. We'll say, ain't that a shame?
While he and Fats are credited with introducing the unique sound of New Orleans music to the world, that later came to be called rock and roll, Bartholomew says from the moment he met Fats in a little club in the Ninth Ward called The Hideaway, they were just doing what he calls letting it all hang out.
And man, once he got on the piano and started jamming and jamming and jamming, they started jumping on the floor and everything, man. I went down, see, tell everybody fighting in there or something. They were having a damn good time.
You knew you had met a special musician when you saw Fats?
That's right. What I did, took my trumpet out and started jamming with him. And man, we just stayed there and were thinking about what time it was. 6 o'clock in the morning, we're still doing the same thing, just letting it all hang out.
Dave and Fats collaborated on 50 songs together, including Blue Monday, I'm Walking, Blueberry Hill, Ain't That a Shame, and Walking to New Orleans. Besides Fats, though, Dave also produced and arranged for other New Orleans artists, among them Lloyd Price, Smiley Lewis, and Shirley and Lee. And though he loves producing and arranging, it's playing the trumpet he enjoys most.
Still got it.
Trying to get it.
That's what I'm talking about.
Back here in the studio, we continue our interview with musicologist and Fats Domino biographer Rick Coleman. What did you think about that guy? We can't figure out whether he's 89, 90, or 91. You're the biographer.
We'll let him have whatever he wants. But
we said at the outset these two men were from worlds apart. You did a little research on that.
Well, actually, their families are both from along the Mississippi River in sugarcane country. But the difference is that Fats was from a very private Creole French family. His parents spoke French. And Dave came from kind of a broken family, and he had to kind of raise himself. So it was hard on him, and he kind of developed his own little tough personality, which, you know, was a very great attribute.
But they were going in opposite directions. Mm-hmm. Music style-wise. Mm-hmm. Dave was this suave guy who wanted to be like Count Basie and
right,
Duke Ellington.
Exactly.
Fats Domino was the boogie-woogie king.
Exactly. There was a very different style. Dave was actually very sophisticated. He came out of the big band tradition, and everybody had to dress up when they went to Dave's concerts. And Fats would actually show up in his overalls with patches on him at his shows. And
no kidding.
Yes, that's right. And he would play piano the boogie-woogie during the breaks, okay, of Dave's shows. And Earl Palmer, Dave's great drummer, once got Fats up there to play the piano in the break, and Dave told him, I told you not to let that guy play, and Earl said, I forgot.
So how did they end up getting together?
What happened is that Lou Chud, who was a record company man from Hollywood, came to New Orleans looking for talent. He had actually met Dave before, and Dave was showing him some talent, but he didn't show him Fats. A disc jockey named Papa Stoppa, the original Duke Thiel, mentioned Fats and said he played down at the Hideaway, and Lou loved boogie-woogie piano players, so he says, told Dave, we got to go see this guy. So they went and saw him and knocked Lou's Chud's socks off, and so he said, you got to record him. And so Fats was doing a song called Junker's Blues, which is an old drug anthem, mm-hmm. and they changed the lyric to from They Call Me the Junker to They Call Me the Fat Man, and that's how it became a classic and possibly the first rock and roll song of all time.
Well, you heard Bartholomew say that his favorite song that he recorded with Fat was Ain't That a Shame.
Oh, yeah. That's so historic. Because what happened is that Fats supposedly heard a lady beating on a baby, and she said, he said, "Ain't that a shame?" And so he came up with that little simple lyric. He said, "You made me cry when you said goodbye, ain't that a shame?" And Dave said, "You got to have more words than that. That doesn't tell a whole story." So Dave wrote elaborate lyrics. That's the big difference between their songwriting styles.
But they both wrote mm-hmm. together.
Well, insofar as one would come up with a song and the other would add his own stuff to it.
Yeah, what I'm getting at mm-hmm. is that it wasn't Bartholomew doing all the writing.
Right, exactly. Well, actually, a lot of it was Dave Fats came up with the idea, and Dave added his little thing to it or arranged it, you know.
So they made a great team.
They were an awesome team.
But like most teams and most relationships, there's a falling out at some point. Mm-hmm. What led to the falling out? You were instrumental in getting them together because you worked with us on a documentary. When they first got together after a 15-year split right here in these studios, what led to the falling out between the two?
Well, they had always had different personalities. Dave was kind of over the top, front man, and Fats is kind of he's a homebody, but he loves entertaining. It's like even his concerts, he's playing for his little crowd, mm-hmm. and he loves little small audiences. But Fats is kind of easygoing, shy kind of guy, and Dave's over the top. But anyway, so they just had a falling out, an argument over different things over the years. And it hit a point at one time in the late 90s, and they kind of, late 80s. Mm-hmm. And they kind of fell out over, some little insult that Dave took. And it wasn't anything big, but, they just stopped talking.
Well, they're back together now forever.
Yes, they are.
Last question. What are you going to talk about when you deliver your lecture at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame ceremony?
Well, I've got to talk about their place in history, obviously, and their significance insofar as bringing not only the New Orleans rhythms, the heavy beats that from New Orleans back into popular music after they had kind of died out in World War II with the big bands, and that brought rhythm and blues and into the mainstream, and it became called rock and roll. Okay, but also I want to talk a little bit about the hard times they went to, the Blue Monday stuff I was mentioning earlier, and just put it all together and kind of say how significant that they were in the second half of the 20th century and have influenced our lives to this day.
All right. Rick Coleman, it's always a pleasure talking to you.
Absolutely.
And an education. And
you too.
And good luck on your lecture.
Thank
at the
you.
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Thank you for your great work.
You're very welcome. That's all the time we have, folks. Our thanks to historian and biographer Rick Coleman. And congratulations to Fats Domino and Dave Bartholomew on their week-long tribute by the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, which culminates in a big concert Saturday night, November 13th in Cleveland, featuring a host of musicians and entertainers from New Orleans. That concludes this week's segment of The Hot Seat. Thank you all for watching. Now let's head back over to the news desk.